Be a part of the best pro wrestling podcast today by supporting the Going In Raw Patreon. You can enjoy access to the live taping of the show, exclusive merchandise, and patron-only episodes, and so much more. Support Going In Raw today. Click the link in the description. Hey, friendo, Steve here.
Ed Larson.
With Extreme Rules around the corner, we thought it'd be fun to take a look at the least extreme wrestlers in history.
So here you go. Here are five of the worst hardcore champions of WWE and WCW.
British Bulldog. Not to take anything away from Bulldog's illustrious career, but nothing about Davey Boy Smith screamed hardcore.
The same can't be said about his former tag team partner, the Dynamite Kid. Years of high-flying moves and drug abuse have made him a hardcore bummer to be around.
Just ask his wife. I think there was like a documentary talking about putting a shotgun at her.
I know.
Damn, dude.
Wrestling's a rough business.
Yeah, that's an understatement. Sean Stasiak! A bunch of you might be saying, who? And a bunch more are probably like, oh, not this guy.
Before he became a pioneer in chiropractic, he was a very bro-ish WCW wrestler. Leathery skin, frosted tips. I thought he had tribal tattoos when I looked at his picture. He doesn't, but you get the idea.
Yeah. He was literally named Meat at one point.
And he was the WWF Hardcore Champion 15 times with a combined title reign of less than a day.
Again, the 24/7 rule is completely ridiculous, and I say they need to bring it back.
For every belt.
Yeah. For every belt. Really? Okay, I like that.
Why not?
Eric Bischoff! Generally speaking, Bischoff has ruined virtually everything he's gotten his hands on. And when he somehow briefly held the WCW hardcore strap, he sullied a totally meaningless belt even more.
The high point of his career was when he shouted, "We are in control!" during the NWO theme, really.
That's really true. That's not even the best line of the song, though. That honor goes to Scott Hall when he says, "Kick him when he's down. It's easier to reach him." Again, wise philosophy.
It really is.
Gerald Briscoe! One of the more interesting things about the WWF Hardcore title was that it had to be defended 24/7. Anyone could take the belt off you at any time.
The downside of that was it usually passed around like a hot potato, and far too often ended up around the waist of someone who was in no way hardcore.
Sure, Gerald Briscoe was a multiple-time champion back in the 70s, but by the time he won the Hardcore title, he was one of Vince McMahon's comedic stooges.
He wasn't very extreme. But he was extremely funny.
Mr. McMahon. I loved his accent. Hey, Mr. McMahon.
Before we get to number one, here are some dishonorable mentions.
Maven, the very first Tough Enough winner.
What of Godfather's Hose? Again, the hardcore title was passed around like the case of the clap, so.
Three count. It was a WCW boy band. WCW had a boy band.
Terry Runnels. Did she hold the hardcore title before or after she showed her vagina live on Raw? Actually, based on that one act of exhibitionism, maybe we should include her in the list of the top hardcore champions.
I think the fact that she's romantically linked to New Jack alone is enough to put her on the list of top hardcore champions. But showing off her pussy live on air is a good reason too. Norman Smiley! He's apparently an integral part of NXT and has been a true professional for decades now. But his most memorable run was as the cowardly yet comedic WCW hardcore champ in the late 90s.
He used to protect himself in hockey gear and football helmets, yet still would fumble his way to victories even after trying to lose the matches.
This was, of course, after introducing the wrestling world to the Big Wiggle, his little dance. Can you please demonstrate?
Something like this, wasn't it?
That's right, then he would do the spanking thing.
Spanking. Norris Smiley was great.
Oh, he was fantastic.